In this last module of the Wisconsin Paramedic EMS Fundamentals curriculum, we will look at the importance of medical terminology for the paramedic. This particular module is not designed to delve into individual medical words, terms, or their construction. Rather, this module provides an overview of the importance of utilizing proper medical terminology for the paramedic. Once completed with this module, you should be able to explain the impact of utilizing proper medical terminology in both written and oral communications with colleagues and other healthcare professionals to ensure quality patient care. Needless to say, paramedics are very highly trained and educated EMS providers who are also an integral part of the broader healthcare system within their respective regions. Paramedics are indeed involved in the practice of medicine, and regardless of whether the paramedic's employment status is volunteer, full-time, or somewhere in between, paramedics are still considered to be allied health professionals. With this being said, it is of obvious importance that paramedics are familiar and comfortable with medical terminology, as they will be interfacing with other healthcare providers who will expect the paramedics to utilize the same language, words, and terms of art. Paramedics must also complete patient care reports, and the quality of that documentation can have an impact on the patient's subsequent care within the healthcare system, while also reflecting upon the competence of the paramedic if the patient care report is ever introduced as evidence in a civil lawsuit. Generally speaking, most medical terminology is derived from either Latin or Greek origins. Latin is often associated with the body's anatomic structures, while Greek words serve as the basis for various disease-related terms. Some medical terminology within the modern practice of medicine is derived from the name of the person who first discovered, invented, or described the thing being named. These terms are known as eponyms and would include examples such as Apgar score, Foley catheter, and Babinski reflex. Many medical terms are actually built by combining grammatical components of words. There is the base upon which the term is built, otherwise known as the root word. A prefix is added to the front of this root word, while a suffix is added to the end of the root word. Combined, the prefix, root word, and suffix convey a specific meaning to the healthcare provider. While not all root words have a prefix or suffix, the addition of those elements further define that root word. Prefixes often change the meaning of a medical term by defining or describing the what, how, why, or when of the root word. The location or intensity of the subsequent root word is often associated with the prefix to that root word. Suffixes, on the other hand, are usually added to a root word to specify a procedure, condition, or disease. A suffix may also be added to a root word to change the word from a noun to a descriptive adjective. As you proceed through subsequent modules, the meaning and use of these various prefixes, root words, and suffixes will be further defined to help build your paramedic-level medical terminology vocabulary. Another aspect of medical terminology is that many words are abbreviated or represented by symbols to shorten conversations or subsequent documentation. So long as these terms of art are universally recognized and accepted within the medical professions, their use should be acceptable in most communications with other healthcare professionals. Saying O2 is shorter than oxygen and is a recognized abbreviation within the practice of medicine. A circled L or R on a patient care report refers to either the patient's left or right side, respectively. While it may seem logical to shorten words or phrases in some communications to be more efficient, doing so can indeed cause problems if confusion results from the use of non-standardized or particular abbreviations or symbols. Some organizations have even published lists of abbreviations or symbols that should never be used in medical communications given the propensity or likelihood for errors in interpretation. For example, many paramedics refer to morphine as MSO4. The problem is that some healthcare providers confuse that abbreviation with magnesium sulfate, which is often abbreviated as MgSO4. Some EMS providers use SS as an abbreviation for signs and symptoms, but other providers use the same abbreviation to refer to a sliding scale for insulin, or, depending upon the quality of the paramedic's handwriting, the two S's could be confused for two fives. As far as medical root words are concerned, they are often associated with specific body structures or body systems. The root word cardi or cardio, for example, refers to the heart and serves as a root for numerous related terms like bradycardic, cardiology, and cardiovert. Ultimately, being able to appropriately use and understand medical terminology is of critical importance for the paramedic to ensure he or she can fully and effectively communicate with other paramedics, EMS providers, nurses, physicians, and healthcare professionals to provide high-quality, effective healthcare to his or her patients. Again, as you proceed through your paramedic training and education, you will be exposed in much greater depth to medical terms that are often built from common prefixes, root words, and suffixes. The point of this module was to underscore the importance of garnering familiarity with and comfort in hearing and using medical terminology. Paramedics are allied health professionals who must be fluent in the language of medicine to fully participate as an integral piece of the healthcare system. Given your completion of this module, you should be able to explain the impact of utilizing proper medical terminology in both written and oral communications with colleagues and other healthcare professionals to ensure quality patient care. This presentation was prepared by Waukesha County Technical College in Pewaukee, Wisconsin, and is distributed with an Attribution Non-Commercial Share Alike 4.0 International Creative Commons License. Copyright 2019 Waukesha County Technical College. For information on WCTC's numerous fire and EMS educational offerings, please visit us online at wctc.edu.